G'day everyone, my name is Gary and today we are going to learn how to use Python to code in LEGO Spike Prime. So before we get started, we are assuming that you have had some experience with LEGO Spike Prime. You've started making some programs and making some models, and you've started coding using the Scratch 3 language, which is great because the Python language is really easy to learn. And especially if you have some knowledge of the Scratch version of the code, then Python is going to be very easy to pick up. Python is also very useful in other areas as well. A lot of people use it for data analytics, building things like websites and computer programs. And Python is just really, really fun to use as well. So I hope this lesson is going to be fun for you. And I'm going to start off by teaching you the basics of Python before learning how to apply some of it to our Spike Prime robot. Today we're going to start off by building the driving base 2 model. So if you go into your Spike Prime software, I want you to build this model. Go into build and then scroll down to driving base 2. Okay. When you build driving base 2, you'll build the normal driving base and then you'll build the tools and accessories. We just need to build the sensors and the manipulating arm on the robot. You don't need all the other stuff, but you can build it too if you want to. Okay. And once you've finished building, then you can continue on with the lesson. All right, so here is my version of the driving base 2. As you can see, we have, it's quite feature packed, okay? So we've got two wheels, one on the left and one on the right, and each wheel is controlled by a motor. This is going to be really important because when one wheel moves forward, when one wheel is spinning forward and then the other wheel, this wheel on the left is also spinning at the same speed, spinning forward, then this whole robot is going to move forward. And on the reverse, it's going to be the same. So if this right wheel is spinning backwards and then this left wheel is also spinning backwards, then it's going to move backwards. But what if I want to turn? What if I want to make, say, a right-hand turn? Well, if both of the wheels were moving forward, it would move forward. But then if I want to turn towards the right, then I slow down the wheel on the right-hand side and then it will make a gentle turn towards the right because the left wheel is still moving. And same way for turning left. If I was moving forward and I wanted to turn left, then the left wheel just simply slows down and then the robot will turn towards the left. Pretty simple stuff. We also have some sensors, and today we're going to focus on this one, the distance sensor. This distance sensor is pointing forward and it's going to help us identify if there are obstacles in front of the robot. So we're going to learn how to do some code get started with Python, but then after that we are going to make the robot move and also react to obstacles by using the distance sensor. Okay, so let's jump into the Spike Prime software. After you've built the driving base, go back into Home, then click on New Project. Once you name this project CA_Python1, because this is going to be our first Python project. And then we click on the Python icon over here, and then click create. All right, already we have some code that is imported into the coding environment here. You see up the top, it looks like a big bunch of mumbo jumbo, but don't be afraid of it. This is just Spike Prime importing all the LEGO Robotics specific classes to Python. Because if you think about it, Python doesn't have any kind of code or any knowledge of LEGO robots, right? Python is just its own language. But in order for it to to interact with different motors, different sensors, and the hub of the robot, it needs to learn what these things can do. So this is what the import does at the start. It actually imports the information from the people who built Lego Spike Prime, and it makes it available for us to code later on. So that's really important. So that's why you see up the top of the code it says import da 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 da. It's all because we need to make sure that Python understands what it is coding for. Okay, let's continue. Over here, we have the hub equals prime hub. Okay, so prime hub is a class that's imported from up here. See, prime hub. And what it does is we are actually creating an object called hub, and we're calling it hub. Okay, so this hub can be changed into whatever we want. Okay, so in fact, we'll change it now to driving base. Okay, driving base, because we can name this object whatever we want. It doesn't have to be called hub, but this bit here, it needs to be called prime hub because prime hub is a thing that we imported. All right, so the driving base is a prime hub object. Here we got hub. Oh, remember we've renamed it driving base, so let's copy and paste it over here. Driving base dot light matrix dot show image happy. Okay, so what does this mean? All these dots. This is called dot notation, and what it does is it's going in, we're saying to go into the driving base, which is the prime hub. Dot light matrix. So we're looking for a light matrix inside driving base. And then inside the light matrix, we're looking for a method called show image. And then we're saying to show image happy. So what this is doing is it's making looking for the driving base, looking for the light matrix in the driving base, and then looking for a method that says to show an image called happy. So if I run this code, and I haven't done anything except for renaming the hub, right? All it's going to do is show a smiley face on your hub. So let's try it. Let's connect it up and see what it does. So go on to the top left, hit the connect hub, connect via Bluetooth. And then on your Spike Prime, there is a Bluetooth button on the top right corner. So I'll just show you where it is. Over here, there is a little Bluetooth button up the top where my finger is. Oh, we'll make sure we turn on the robot first. And then we click on the Bluetooth button. On the Bluetooth button, and then it's going to start flashing and making the sound. We go into Spike Prime again. Okay, so we restarted the hub and we installed the update. Now let's test the code. So once it's connected, hit the play button, and then you should see a smiley face on your hub. Yep, and there is on my hub, so you can have a look. Here we are. So here we have a smiley face, which is kind of good, but we wanted to do something cooler. And that's what we are going to do. So now we want to use code to actually move the robot because a smiley face is cool, but it's going to be much cooler if we can get this robot to move. So let's look at our code. You can see how at the top we have all our imported code. And I'm going to teach you a trick now. So go all the way up to the top, hit enter to make a line break. And then what I want to do is to use the hash symbol, which is a shift 3. What this hash symbol represents is something called a comment in Python. A comment is where Python will ignore everything you write on a line after this hash symbol. And what it's useful for is to make it so that we can communicate with other people who are programming the robot or who are reading the code so that they can understand it easier. Okay, so here I'm just going to say this is where we do our imports. Here is where we say this is where we create our objects. And then here is where we execute the code. Okay, so in Spike Prime, it's already laid out like this, but it doesn't explicitly teach you how to organize your code, okay? But what these comments are designed to do is it's going to make it so that it's easier for you to organize your code later, okay? So this next thing that we are going to do is just like in Spike Prime in the Scratch software, how you have to define the movement motors. Well, in Python, we do the same thing, except we call them motor pairs. Okay, so let's try that. So we're going to call it our new object, movement motors equals. And then up here, it's got motor pair, which is what we are expecting from Spike Prime. So here we go, motor pair. And you see how it pops up with this drop-down menu? This is called code hinting, okay? So when you're starting to type code, code hints make it so that it can suggest some functionality to you. And what it does is it makes it so that you don't have to type as much. And it also reduces the number of errors that you have, because when you select something from the code hinting, you don't have to type it, and then you can avoid having typos then. So motor pair is what we need. And then motor pair is a method that takes in two parameters. And these two parameters have to be inside brackets, and each parameter has to be separated by a comma. Okay, so we'll if you've built your robot correctly, then your left motor should be at C, and your right motor should be at D. So here, we're going to put C in quotation marks, comma D in quotation marks. Why do we use quotation marks? Well, the reason is simple. It's because, remember how we renamed hub driving base over here? Well, when we rename an object, objects are written as they are. They don't have any quotation marks. If I didn't write quotation marks beside the C, it would be looking for an object called C, but it doesn't exist because we never defined anything called C, right? So we need to tell Python that this is a letter C by putting these quotation marks around it, okay? And these quotation marks don't have to be the single ones. They can be the double quotation marks as well. They don't make any difference, okay? You can do double quotation marks or single quotation marks. The reason you would want to use one over another is because you would probably want to have quotation marks in the quotation marks, and then in that case, you will have to switch them out. But for now, we just have to set movement motors to be equal to a motor pair, and it is C and D, right? And then after we execute our code, we show the happy face, and then here we want to say movement motors, and then you see how code hinting popped up and made it really easy for me to type, dot move. Okay, we're going to say dot move, and then move has three arguments, okay? The arguments are the value, so we wanted to say move 20 centimeters, so 20, comma, and then centimeters is going to be our unit, so cm, and then our steering, we wanted to go straight, so just like in Scratch, negative makes it go left and positive makes it go to the right, zero makes it go straight. And you'll notice that I don't put quotation marks around my numbers, okay? In Python, your numbers get treated differently, and we don't need to put quotation marks around them, because if we put quotation marks around them, then it will think of the number as a string, which is not what we want. But here we have the code to make the robot move forward 20 centimeters. So let's try it by hitting the play button. Yep, it works. I'll just have a closer view for you. There we go. Robot moves forward 20 centimeters. That's fantastic. All right. So now we know how to create objects and how to move the robot using a motor pair. But now let's ramp up the difficulty a little bit. Let's make it so that we move the robot forward and keep on moving until we detect an obstacle coming in towards the distance sensor. That would be really cool if we can do that all in the first lesson. So let's check this out. So just like how we define the motor pair, we need to define the distance sensor as well. So let's call our distance sensor distance sensor equals distance sensor. Oh, you see how I started typing in capital? So all the classes you'll see start with a capital letter. So that's why when we're naming the object, we start with a lowercase letter. But for a class, we always start with a capital letter. And we see distance sensors are over here. And then we have to also tell it where the distance sensor is connected to. So here, our distance sensor is connected to F, if you built it correctly. So we put it on F. And that helps us define the distance sensor. And now instead of the movement motors moving a fixed amount, we're going to comment that out. And then we're going to say movement motors dot start. Okay. What does this do? This just starts the motors moving, and they won't stop. Okay. So until we give a command to our distance sensor. So we go distance sensor dot wait for distance closer than, and then here we put say 15 centimeters. So 15 and then comma cm. After it detects something closer than 15 centimeters, we go movement motors dot stop. Okay, so this should make it so that the movement motors will keep rolling until it detects an object closer than 15 centimeters on the distance sensor. Yep. That worked. Let's see it again in close up. There we go. Cool. So that is the basics of using Python in Spike Prime. As you can see, it's actually quite easy to learn. And later on, we're going to learn how to use functions and also learn some more advanced ways of how we can code your robot using Python. So if you like this video, make sure you like and subscribe to my channel, and I will see you on the next one. Bye bye.